Since the 1st of April, Automobilista 2 is finally available for everyone in the Steam store, as it is also one of, if not the most anticipated game for 2020 in the sim racing community. We are going to take a quick look at how it compares to Project Cars 2 and if it lives up to our expectations or not. As many of you probably know, Automobilista 2 is directly built on a Madness engine from Slightly Mad Studios, which also happens to be the building ground for Project Cars 2. The moment it got released on the Steam store, I made sure to get myself a copy of the game and install it. As I first launched it and got to the main menu, there were three options available: Quick Race, Test Day and Multiplayer. Now the first thing I did was to hop into a testing day at, you probably guessed it, the Red Bull Ring. But, and I'm very grateful to Risa for this, not the current layout, but rather the historic version. Before I'm going to focus on how the physics actually feel, AI behavior and so on, I just wanted to throw in a disclaimer that there currently seems to be a bug which messes with the physics and the force feedback in AMS 2. When I finished my first lap, I was really disappointed because every car felt like it was constantly understeering, and as soon as you went even hard from the throttle, it would instantly snap on you. The force feedback also seemed to be quite bad, as it felt like driving on a very slippery surface the whole time. However, this didn't make sense to me, as the most hyped sim racing game of 2020 couldn't really be that bad, right? So I went on, put my Thrustmaster T300 RS back on normal mode, restarted my PC, and suddenly, Automobilista 2 felt like a completely different game. Now it made a whole lot of sense for this game to be so hyped. Anyway, back to my second first experience. AMS 2 seems to be a mix of one of the best handling simulator, which happens to be R Factor 2, and one of the best looking one, which would be Project Cars 2. Now, Risa could get this mixture completely wrong by taking, or rather not completely reworking, some aspects of the Madness engine, which is mostly really inconsistent curb behavior, where it is a gamble whether you can pass a curb, it sucks you off track, or instantly spins you out. So, is this the case? Are the curbs still the same? Most definitely not. Automobilista 2 doesn't feel like Project Cars 2 in the slightest. The force feedback is great, even though a bit too powerful for my personal liking. But fiddling with the settings a bit led to me receiving what I was hoping for, without losing any information communicated by the steering wheel. Now, onto the curbs. This one is actually quite funny, as I figured that the historic version of the Red Bull Ring hadn't too much curbing, so I chose to switch to a widely known Brazilian Formula 1 track to do one or two laps with the Formula 3 car. But my initial thought of doing one or two testing laps was soon to be replaced by, yeah, just one more lap, this is just too much fun to end it now. And consequently, wanting to do a race against the AI on this very track. So yeah, the curbs feel very similar to the ones in R Factor 2, as well as the Formula cars do. Sadly, AMS 2 hasn't any GT3 or GT4 cars in its lineup yet, so I couldn't compare the handling in this case. Let's go straight ahead though, to me doing a 10 laps race against the AI and simultaneously talking about Automobilista 2's graphics. As you probably could already tell from the video so far, the graphics are amazing. The game looks pretty similar to Project Cars 2, but a lot more vibrant and realistic. Additionally, it seems to be rather light on graphics cards, as I'm able to run it on 1080p with everything maxed out without any lags whatsoever on my good old GTX 1060. And even if you may experience a stutter or two, you can simply tune down the graphics a bit and it will still look amazing. However, this leads me to my first rather neutral experience about the game. The AI acts really strange at times in AMS 2. Just take a look at this short clip here. We are going side by side into the braking zone in turn 1. My opponent brakes a bit later than me, crashes into the other AI in front of it, comes back on my lane and almost stops mid-corner. Now, this is sadly not a one-time incident, as such scenes happen rather often. I also have a slight feeling that the AI in general is a bit off. In some corners, like turn 1, they are able to brake a lot later than me and carry much more speed. Whereas in other corners, like in this one for example, an overtake around the outside feels like the easiest thing to do, as the AI basically stops in the middle of the corner. Let's not forget though that AMS 2 is still in the early access phase for at least 2 more weeks. There is a good chance that there are still some bugs in the game which could lead to AMS 2 not functioning properly on some setups, like I mentioned in the beginning of the video. However, I'm still convinced with a bit more content, which is already confirmed by the developers, and slight improvements regarding the AI, Automobilista 2 could be one of the greatest simulations in this decade, like Automobilista 1 was in the previous one. In my opinion, this game is a gem in the making and already worth the 27 euros. Now, if there happen to be any significant updates for AMS 2 in the future, I will keep you guys posted. So be sure to hit that subscribe button in order to not miss anything. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers, guys.